Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ Chen Design. Today we're gonna talk about this really common design for locking style ring with the B setting for today's video tutorial. Let's get started. We are going to starting at the front view. Let's go ahead to creating a diameter 16 circle, and we're gonna coming into the top view to do the design that we wanted for locking looking. So I'm gonna use the arc tool. Starting over here, the goal is setting up about 1.6 millimeter stone B setting all the way. So I'm going to do something the size that we're able to compensate the stone size. So let's go ahead to draw something over here. You can make it wider or thinner for whatever that work for you. And I'm going to use the blend command because it's just gonna make a very nice and smooth connection over there. And if you like that, just go ahead to mirror to the other side. And let's go ahead to join all of them. So that's the first curve we have, and I would like to have the ring shank width is about 2 millimeters, so to set 1.6 millimeter stone. So I'm gonna have something like this, like offset, so it will be the equal distance. The next step that we wanted to do is make sure those two curves is following around this circle. So let's go ahead to use the curve from the two view. We're gonna set up this one and this one. So you see this following the circle. Let me do one more time, this one and this one. Let me turn into the red color so it's easier for you to see. Now, if everything look nice to you, we're gonna have this one and this one as our cutting object, and we are going to trim anything that we don't need over there. Okay, so we can hide this one now. Now with this curve over there, if it's everything look nice to you, we're going to creating the profile. So basically, I'm just gonna draw a rectangle snapping into the endpoint to the endpoint here. And coming into the top view, I like to have it somewhere close to 2 millimeter there as the thickness. And we can simply just copy that one from this point to this point. Or you can use a mirror either way. So now we have everything set up. Let's give it a try. We're gonna use the sweep to rail. We're not gonna do rail one, rail two, and cross section over there. And we'll get something like this, right? So I don't really like this looking over there. And also there's no control at this point. We cannot edit anything on this one. So what I like to do is I'm gonna pick up those two, and I'm going to use the rotate tool, and we're gonna rotate 90 degrees with the copy equal yes. So we're bringing this over here. Let's move this one to the quadrant over here and move this one to the quadrant over here. Okay, let's do another test. We want to go to the surface, sweep to rail. This is rail one, rail two. You're gonna go from here to here to here and come back to this one and make sure that they are facing the same direction for the arrow, right? Remember recorded history so we can do some editing later on. All right, make sure the maintain height is also on. So now we have something like this. Let's do another test by rotating the guy from this point to that point with the copy is on, and make sure that you record the history so you got something like this. All right, they look like it's like completely flush on the top. So we are going to bring up this curve, and then to make it a little bit thicker by pulling up the control point. And because I have history, and then you can see they automatically update like that. So now everything is done. I'm going to pick up this curve and this curve, send into the other layer, and we are going to take a look on this one. So let's go ahead to explode it. And then we are going to delete those curves, and we are going to connect it back with a straight line there. Once we are done, let's go ahead to J join it. All right, so we can simply just have that one to mirror to the other side. All we need to do is a sweep one rail. We're gonna pick up this to this. And we don't need to close the sweep because we just need to have the bottom ring shank. All right, so now everything is set there. I like to do is cap individual of them. So that one's cap, this one's cap, and this one is cap. The reason I wanted to do that is because I wanted to have the fitted edges. So I wanted to fit the edge individually instead of bowling together and fit it. So this is really important. Fit it first, bowling after. So let's go ahead to fit this one. We want a radius inside for 0.65. So I'm gonna pick up all of this coming over here and finish over here. Let's do 0.65 on all of them. All right, the second thing we wanted to do is the fitted edges on the top nearby the stone. So I like to do 0.2 over here. So let's go ahead to pick up both outside, inside, outside, and inside. So if everything look all right, you can bowling union together. If the rest of it is the stone setting. I have a whole playlist for the stone setting. You can go ahead to check on that one. We have been using the B setting in other videos, so I don't want to bother you with the same content. You can also check on my stone setting course online. It has more than just B setting, all different kind of a setting, and plus how to make different kind of a stone over there. Check it out, Richards, for free. Please like and comment and share my video. And don't forget to subscribe it with the little bells on. Thank you, and I will see you next.